What's wrong?
The pulse rates are spiking again. They're huge.
Are you serious?
Have you ever wondered why things like this happen? Why are engineering marvels like this able to experience things like this and broken down into pieces? In this video, we will talk about what happens behind the phenomena and explain it to you in a nutshell. Before explaining about the phenomena, we first need to know the basic about materials.
Humans have unique characteristics, and that also applies to material in this world. When humans have strength, materials do also have strength. For example, when we are exercising, we will reach our limit and cannot do more than what we have done. Materials also experience the same thing. We call that phenomenon fatigue. And if an accident occurs, the bone on our body may break because of excessive external force. Materials do also break when experience loads exceeding the maximum load that the materials can withstand.
Before we dive deeper, we need to understand there are two different types of material. There are brittle and ductile materials. For an analogy, when brittle material experience fracture, there will be no deformation prior, like when we are eating biscuit. While ductile material is a material like chewing gum. Before we pull apart the chewing gum into two parts, the chewing gum will stretch first. Have you ever pulled apart a rubber band and split it into two pieces? The amount of load that you apply divided by the cross-section area of the rubber band is the strength of the material. Material strength, in summary, is the ability of material to withstand deformation or change its shape before its shape permanently changes.
Materials might break if we give loads more than the material can withstand, but in some cases, material can break before the loads reach its strength. For example, if there are flaws inside the material, it will be easier to break the material without giving it too much force. And that's why we need to learn a property called fracture toughness.
Fracture toughness is an indication of the amount of stress required to propagate a pre-existing flaw like a crack. A parameter called the stress intensity factor is used to determine the fracture toughness of most materials. The purpose of a fracture toughness test is to measure the resistance of material to the presence of a flaw in terms of the load required to cause brittle or ductile crack extension in a standard specimen containing a fatigue pre-crack.
So, why is fracture mechanics really important? The answer is really, really simple. Because it can save lives. We can avoid things that we don't want to happen. As we may know, engineering products are filled with defects such as cracks. The crack might take lives if they are not handled properly. To avoid that, we need to consider the crack within the product so that we may know the maximum load that the product can handle before it breaks. Let's take an example of flight Aloha 243.
Flight Aloha 243 suffered an explosive decompression on April 28, 1988. When the explosion occurred, the airplane's fuselage ceiling was torn open. Fortunately, the captain was able to land the aircraft safely. Prior to the flight, inspection was done and nothing wrong was found. So, what happened to the aircraft? Post crash failure analysis was done and it was found that the accident was caused by improper maintenance of the fuselage. Maintenance program of Aloha Airline failed to detect the existence of fatigue crack near the rivet joint and caused failure at the joint. From this case, we may know that cracks have a large impact on the mechanical property of a product. So, that's why learning fracture mechanics is really important.
That's all for the lesson today. See you.